After knowing both the new and rerun banners on patch 2.4 are just mediocre, it turns out players' attention will further get distracted by the recent info on the new 2.5 character skin, and one of them is Fei Xiao. Rumors have spread across the internet that she's going to be OP. Well, we are talking about accurate level of OP here. But is it true that she's the next best damage dealer unit that we are going to have in the future? How good is she, or is there any flaw that we could find in her kit? Today we are going to get to know her more, and this is what you can find from this video. And let's start! Fei Xiao is going to be a 5-star limited Han Win DPS. Her main source of damage is her ultimate, but also capable of unleashing follow-up attack through her talent. Like Acheron, she doesn't use the typical energy bar and instead uses a unique stacking mechanism, which we will discuss more in detail throughout the video. Her base attack is 601, and what surprises me already, her base speed is 125, breaking the record of the highest base speed in Honkai Star Rail characters. And her trace stats are going to be 28% attack, 12% crit rate, and 5 speed. Her basic attack offers nothing special, just dealing wind damage to a single enemy, and doesn't need to be upgraded once you have her. And her skill, she also dealing wind damage to one target, having 240% multiplier and gain her a 10% advance forward. And then you need to familiarize yourself with her stacking mechanic that is located in her talent, since this is going to be crucial for her ultimate. That is why I intended to discuss her talent first. Just like Acheron, Fei Xiao doesn't use energy bar, but instead use a stack called Flying Aureus. Once you have 6 stacks of this, you can then activate your ult, and the maximum number of stack that you can have is 12. More stacks means more damage. But how do we get this Flying Aureus? It is stated here that she can obtain 1 point or stack for every 2 attacks that her ally perform. And in one of her showcase videos, this also includes Fei Xiao's action. More attack means more stacks. That means follow-up unit like Topaz can really have a good synergy with her, since she and Nambi will deal damage frequently, thus generating more stacks for her. And then after her team perform any attack, she will then launch a follow-up attack once. This can only be triggered one time per turn and will be reset after Fei Xiao's next turn arrives. So it's kind of like Kafka's follow-up attack, I guess. But since Fei Xiao is a unit that already has a high base speed, meaning she can perform this frequently. And now, let's move on to her ultimate. Her ultimate can be cast only if you have 6 stacks or above. It has the multiplier ranging from 840 until 1680% from Fei Xiao's attack, depending on how many stacks you currently have when you cast her ult. And yep, that is a huge multiplier we got there. And this ability will reduce enemies' toughness regardless of their weakness. If the target are not yet weakness broken, then Fei Xiao's weakness break efficiency will increase by 100%. Fei Xiao will enter like a storm barrier and unleash multiple slash based on the number of her flying Aureus stacks. And yes, the animation similar to Acheron's. During the multiple instances of attacks, her basic attacks and skill button will be replaced with Bolt Thunder and War Axe. You might want to spam War Axe button when the enemy still has their toughness, since it deals more damage. Right after they break, you can switch to tap Bolt Thunder button, as it deals more damage when the enemy is in weakness broken state. And then she will perform a final hit that is going to deal wind damage equal to 10% of her attack for every point of flying Aureus that she has. If the enemy is in weakness broken, the damage multiplier is increased by 15%. What makes her stacking mechanism feels efficient is that, after doing 6 slashes or above, if the enemy is already dead, she will immediately perform the final hit and will reserve her remaining stacks, so you won't have a hard time collecting it again. So, the ideal situation is to make enemy lose their toughness bar as fast as you can, so you can make the best out of her ultimate damage. One of her traces immediately grants her 4 stacks of flying Aureus at the start of the battle. And then if there are no teammates active in the battle on the field at the start of a turn, receive another 1 stack. I'm not really sure about this one, but I think if the enemies are the one who get their turn first, as soon as the battle begins, Fei Xiao will get 1 stack, so it's 5 now. But you can correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. Thanks to her A4, casting her ultimate is regarded as launching a follow-up attack. Take note that this does not make her ultimate considered as a follow-up damage. So I guess Nambi's marking won't increase Fecha's ult damage, but will still make Nambi's turn advance forward since any kind of follow-up attack will make her turn arrive sooner. So I guess this relic will be one of her best in slot if there are no changes to be made. Don't forget Fecha also has a follow-up attack from her talent that can be activated every time she or her team performs any attacks. Her last traits will increase this ability crit damage by 60%, which is huge. As for her technique, it is similar to Jigglyu's. After casting, she will create a wind dimension that follows the character for 20 seconds. She will pull enemies within a certain range, and after entering combat, her speed will be increased by 35% and immediately gain 1 stack of flying auras. Not only that, when the battle starts, she deals wind damage to all enemies at the start of each wave, and this damage is guaranteed to crit. This ability multiplier will be increased by 100% for every enemy that is pulled before entering the battle, up to a maximum of 1000 multiplier or equal to 5 enemies. Note that this cannot be successfully implemented in MOC since usually there will be only one enemy present before you enter the battle. Fecha's first Eidolon seems a little bit odd, but in a good way, I think. For every flying Aureus consumed, the final hit from her ultimate will additionally deal wind damage to a random enemy. So it's like Argentis ultimate or Yunlin's Intuit call. Does this mean she is more than just a hunt unit whose main target is supposed to be only a single target now? Well, I hope I'm wrong for this one. And her second Eidolon also a game changer to her kit, or at least are supposed to be in her easy role from the beginning. The attack count required to get her stack is reduced by 1, so it means every ally in your party will generate 1 stack of flying Aureus for Fecha every time they deal damage. And I think this is gonna be insane of how fast her ultimate stack is going to be filled with this Eidolon. Since her 3rd and 5th Eidolon only increase the level of her skills, so let's move on to her 4th Eidolon. Just like Topaz Trace, Fecha's skill and basic attack ability now is considered to be a follow-up attack type. This means her basic attack and skill can play a more important role to her kit. And also, this Eidolon is going to be the key to her last win. Fecha's 6th Eidolon granted her an increase in follow-up attack resistance penetration by 20%. Both of her skill and basic attack will deal more damage now. And then her follow-up attack multiplier from the talent also increases by 360%. So her talent multiplier is now around 920, and she can easily trigger this since her speed is quite high to begin with. And this will be considered as ultimate damage. It is crazy knowing how strong her ultimate is going to be, but it is going to be hard to make the best use of her 12 stack ultimate, since it will take several turns to reach full stacks in the middle of the battle, even with full follow-up teams. So if you ask me, what is her best Eidolon to aim for, at least for this early version? I guess it's either her E1 or E2. Her first Eidolon lets her break the hunt type rule by dealing more additional damage to a random enemy other than the primary target. This really helps her in finishing the cycle faster. And then her second Eidolon is going to solve her main problem at this early stage, since now every time she or her team attacks, they will generate 1 stack of flying Aureus. So faster ultimate uptime means more consistent damage output, thus making her easier to clear the permanent content. That's why I think this Eidolon needs to be put somewhere in her traces or talent in the upcoming changes. Besides her number and multiplier, one thing that you must know about what makes her stronger is her signature light cone. For the V1, her LC is going to give her 15% crit rate, and then every time her ally deals damage, the wearer will gain 1 stack of Lumine Flux, where each of these stacks lets the wearer's ultimate damage to ignore 9% of enemy's defense, and it's stackable to 6 times. So 54% defense ignore is just crazy. The signature LC pull value will be high, I guess. Now it's time for us to play a little bit with some numbers. Assuming that she's going to use her signature LC together with Valorous as her relic and Duran as her planner choice, her total attack is going to be this much, and her crit stats are 70% crit rate and 170% crit damage. Note that these stats are example and it may or may not be achievable in the real game, and these stats are not yet including any buffs from her teams. For this calculation, I am going to use the 4th team, which includes Fesha herself, Aventurine, Robin, and Topaz. And these are her numbers. To be honest, I am still not sure whether her ultimate damage is considered as follow-up damage and benefit from Nambi's debuff, so here I calculated both. Another reminder for you guys, for her ultimate numbers, the break damage is not yet included, since I am pretty sure she's going to trigger toughness break when she casts her ult, so this number is probably will be even higher. So overall, her number is actually pretty good, but it's going to be even better if she can somehow gain easier access for her ultimate stacking. With this, we all might agree that she is a Hunt version of Acheron, so Hunt Acheron, since they share similar kind of kit and mechanism. But the difference is, Fesha is not restricted to Nihility teams, so you have more access to use more variety of units. Instead, she needs a team that consists of units that can do a frequent attack in a short amount of time, which is follow-up characters. So it is safe to say that Fesha is restricted to these follow-up units instead of Nihility like Acheron, even though there is not a single word in her description that says so. As expected from our general, Fei Xiao is going to deal a huge number with her great multipliers. Her ultimate also let her to reduce enemies' toughness regardless of their weakness, this making her somehow more flexible DPS for endgame contents. On top of that, she has the highest base speed among all of the existing characters from the game, and this can make building her easier. Hence, you can just focus on more attacks or crits in her substats. Since she has a high speed, it is also making it easier to trigger her passive. Being able to perform more follow-up attacks means she can still deal a good amount of damage in total outside her ultimate. Thus, she can generate more stack for her own ultimate, since apparently her action could also generate 1 point of flying Aureus. Being a unit that is comparable to Acheron, facial animation is also as sick as hers. Having unit like facial in a player's account that has already invested heavily in follow-up teams might be a huge win for them, especially for you guys that really love playing with follow-up takers. But this can also be a huge L to players that are not suited in follow-up playstyles, and thus not invested in many follow-up units from the beginning. Furthermore, despite having a massive multiplier, it is still relatively difficult to fill up 12 stacks for Fischl's ultimate, even though her team already consisted of full follow-up units. Probably several of you guys have seen her showcase video. She deals tons of damage, but behind that numbers, there are units that are struggling to let Fischl reach her full stacks. So overall, she is super strong in this V1, but definitely needs some adjustments here and there. There are still 3 weeks left, so hopefully she will get even better and better in the future. What do you guys think about Fei Xiao? I want to know your personal opinion about her, so you can just leave your comments down below. If you like this video, please consider hit the like button and subscribe if you want. Next, I will be back with Lin Xia's kit video, so stay tuned. And see you humans in a couple of days!